Good evening and welcome to MTV's News Update, May 29, 2020 edition. I'm Ashley Scotland. First, the top stories we are tracking this evening. GCOM moves deadline for national votes recount to June 13. GCOM Commissioner says allegations of migrants voting forwarded to Chief Immigration Officer. Dr. Ali roasts Vincent Alexander over statements made. COVID-19 Task Force rejects the establishment of more counting stations, recount to drag on. And in sport, ICC deferred decision on 2020 T20 World Cup to June 10. More coming up after the break. Stay with us.
Corona, corona, corona. We now want this virus come from here.
Hey Guyana, this is your village boy Terry G, the Guyana Babu, humbly appealing to everyone to please practice social distancing. And remember, you can keep your loved ones safe from this virus by washing your hands proper, proper good with clean water and soap to stop the spread of germs. Ensure you lather well for 10 to 15 seconds, not forgetting your fingertips, fingernails, and back of the hands. If you don't have water, you may use a hand sanitizer. This COVID-19 is no joke. It is overmarked dangerous. And remember, make sure you sanitize all over. We have to get rid of corona. Terry G. Sessa, love you all.
For further information, check our website, www.health.gov.gy, or visit the ministry's Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, or Twitter page.
Let FiberTech help you to renovate, refresh, and redecorate your kitchen. Spice up your kitchen with decorative colors, finishes, and accessories. Choose from an array of designs and beautiful granite colors that are blended to suit your choice. FiberTech Lifetime Kitchen is durable, termites-free, and water-resistant. Enjoy 1-year factory warranty along with our after-sale service. So come on in and let us help you choose wisely.
Everyone is now using Softex toilet tissue. Available in leading supermarkets countrywide, Softex is always silky smooth because it's made from virgin pulp and babies love it. Softex comes available in single rolls, economy pack, six pack, and one dozen packages. Just perfect for any budget. Manufactured and distributed by BPATS Paper Manufacturing, Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, telephone 622-4197.
Start feeling good again with Probiotic XL. Probiotic XL contains a proprietary formula of 10 of the most important probiotics that have been researched and developed to help your body get rid of what's bad for it and help promote what makes you feel good. If leading a healthy life and enjoying every day is something you want to do, then Probiotic XL is for you.
Welcome back. Now for the news in details. The Ghana Elections Commission has set a new date for the completion of the national votes recount after it has become clear the initial 25-day timeline cannot be met. The final date has been set for June 13.
According to the addendum to the gazetted order guiding the recount, The process must be completed on or before June 13. It also says that the commission will decide whether it will request of the chief elections officer to use the data of the recount for his report that has to be presented to the commission. Once that is cleared, the addendum reads that the declaration of the election's winner will be made within 3 days after the commission receives the report. It also says that GCOM will be working with the current 12 counting stations until the process is completed. While the 25-day timeline will be surpassed, the People's Progressive Party Civic had claimed the recount could have been completed in 10 days. The party has also accused the coalition agents of delaying the counting of ballots by making objections they claim are frivolous. However, the coalition have been objecting to names of persons listed as voted, claiming those persons have either died or migrated. The coalition maintains all objections made are credible. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
GCOM Commissioner Vincent Alexander today said the allegations of migrants' names used by persons to vote have been handed over to the Chief Immigration Officer to verify.
The APNU-AFC coalition has been making numerous objections about the names of persons recorded as voted on March 2, 2020. The party's agents claim a number of persons have died and others migrated. Thus, there has been electoral fraud. Today, GCOM Commissioner Vincent Alexander told media operatives that the allegations have been given to the Chief Immigration Officer for verification.
That information, some days ago, would have been forwarded to the Chief Immigration Officer. So they have, in fact, embarked on the process of discerning and determining whether the information is evidential.
Meanwhile, Alexander said there should be no need for the verification of death certificates once they are presented.
I would take a death certificate on the face of the document. It's an official document. Once it's an original document, my disposition would be to take it for what it's worth. I don't see we have to go and verify a death certificate. I don't know that in the course of things, for example, I don't know the court when dealing with wills and things of that nature.
Meanwhile, the coalition has indicated it has turned over some death certificates to GCOM. Godfrey Brooms, MTV News Update.
Meanwhile, presidential candidate of the People's Progressive Party Civic, Dr. Irfan Ali, was not pleased with the utterances of Alexander.
The only fraud in this election is that fraudulent declaration. The evidence is glaring. The evidence is clear. But the APNU-AFC Commissioner Alexander sidesteps the evidence. Would say nothing about that. But would rather pontificate on extraneous issues where no evidence exists, on issues that has no relation to the task at hand. And of course, Mr. Alexander is aware that at the end of the recount and the declaration, if one party feel aggrieved, they can go to an election petition. We have no issue with that. But we have an issue when a sitting commissioner is trying to misdirect the media, the population, and also he's trying to misrepresent the decision of GCOM and the way forward.
City constables have arrested 41 persons who failed to adhere to the 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. curfew. According to the Mayan City Council, they were each placed on $10,000 bail and will appear in court next week to answer to the charge. City Hall also noted that vendors are loitering after 6 p.m. and has committed to beefing up the patrols of the constables. 51 persons have since been fined for failing to wear masks and another 14 for illegal vending. The National COVID-19 Task Force has denied the request of the Ghana Elections Commission to have more workstations added to fasten the recount process being carried out at the Arthur Chong Conference Center.
The rejection letter was dispatched by Dr. Colin James, coordinator of the Health Emergency Operations Center, to GCOM Chairman Justice retired Claudette Singh. The task force said it cannot concede to the request for the installation and operation of additional workstations, as this would be increasing the number of persons at the Arthur Chong Conference Center during the period of the recount. The letter stated that public safety and wellness remains the primary focus, and as such, the request was refused in order to mitigate the negative impact and prevent the spread of COVID-19. The task force had earlier greenlighted the establishment of 2 workstations, adding to the existing 10. The increase significantly boosted the day's output of the recount. Meanwhile, the People's Progressive Party maintains that GCOM does not need the approval of the task force to establish counting stations. The task force is comprised of government politicians and medical professionals. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Cillian Griffith.
Guyana's neighbor, Suriname, could likely undergo an election recount. Current president of Suriname, Desi Bouterse, asking for a recount after initial results indicated a massive loss for his party. His request is yet to be granted. CARICOM and the Organization of American States, OAS, are observing the process. The OAS had said that tight measures are in place to protect its observers. The Federation of Independent Trade Unions of Guyana is calling on GCOM to identify the shortest possible extension to complete the national recount of the March 2 elections.
In recognizing that the initial 25-day deadline is nearing, FITUG in a press release today said the patience of Guyanese has now worn thin, pointing out it is almost 3 months after Elections Day without a winner announced. The release stated that a delay in declaring the results will not be supported by the FITUG. The Federation said with the results being tabulated regionally, the declaration of the national results should be smooth. FITUG stated the completion of the process in the shortest possible time is most important, given the health, economic and social crises the nation is currently facing. The Federation reiterated that the installation of a legitimate government cannot be subjected to further procrastination. Reporting for MTV's News Update, Celine Griffith.
Police, acting on information, went to the home of a farmer at Duvel, Berbice River yesterday to conduct a search for arms and ammunition, but he was not at home. A female sibling, who resides in East Kanji and was present at the house, handed over the rangs and unlicensed pistol. She has since been detained and efforts are being made to contact her brother for questioning. The said rangs then proceeded to another house in the Berbice River at Bartika village, where they conducted a search and found a large quantity of marijuana, which has a street value of $1.6 million. An unlicensed shotgun and several identification documents were also unearthed. Still ahead, PSC calls for home quarantine for Guyanese returning from abroad and minor beaten to death by his friend.
At Decor and Gift Gallery, we have comfortable and unique living room suites. Check out our bonded leather sofa or 3-piece recliner set and much more. Or pick a lovely dining room set to match your home setting. Whatever is your style, we've got it. Shop your living room or dining room sets at Decor and Gift Gallery today.
In light of the coronavirus disease 2019, here are 7 steps to prevent the virus. Step 1, wash your hands frequently. Step 2, avoid touching your eyes, mouth, and nose. Step 3, cover your cough with a bend of your elbow or tissue. Step 4, avoid crowded places. Step 5, stay at home if you feel unwell, even with a slight fever and cough. Step 6, If you have a fever, cough, and difficulty breathing, seek medical care early, but call by phone first. 624-2819 or 624-9355. Step 7. Stay aware of the latest information from WHO. You can visit our website at www.health.gov.gy.
Everything is connected. Our planet, our water sources, including the water we drink. Sometimes harmful bacteria end up in our streams and canals. Although treated, the risks are high. You can prevent this pollution and contamination by maintaining your septic tank and grease traps. Call the experts at Puran Brothers Disposal Incorporated on 264-1239 or 603-5050. Keeping it clean is what we do best.
Modern Optical Service has made it even better by introducing its budgeted spectacle line, starting as low as $10,000 for single vision lens and $12,000 for bifocal lens, available in tinted or clear, complete spectacles at affordable prices. So hurry down to our main office at 316 Middle Street or Lot 14 Diamond Public Road opposite Demerara Bank. Enjoy over 60 years of eye care experience at affordable prices. Modern Optical Service, your eye care professionals.
Beeson Windows and Doors, fully equipped to handle all your commercial projects. Whether you're constructing a small or large commercial building, residential property, or just upgrading your home, they got you covered. Beeson Windows and Doors, providing unmatched quality windows for your home, office, and commercial building. Located at 1228 Eccles Industrial Site. For more information, call 662-4197 or 226-1292.
The Private Sector Commission has presented a list of measures to the National COVID-19 Task Force to help citizens experiencing economic difficulties.
The Private Sector Commission recommended that persons returning to Guyana be given the option of self-quarantine for 2 weeks. The Commission said a penalty of $100,000 should impose if an individual breached the quarantine protocols. The task force had given persons returning to Guyana options to stay at any of its quarantine facilities for free or pay to stay at two hotels designated to provide such services. On March 18th, the Guyana Civil Aviation Authority announced that airports will remain closed to international flights as the number of COVID-19 cases continue to spike in Guyana. Guyana's cases grow almost daily, surpassing 150, despite the measures in the policy. Some persons are not practicing social distancing, as a photograph was circulated on Sunday showing a large gathering of persons on the seashore Abak Marriott Hotel. Luan Williams for MTV's News Update.
Police are on the hunt for a man who allegedly beat his friend to death. Dead is David James, a gold mine of Port Kaituma Region 1. According to the Regional Police Commander, Senior Superintendent Lyndon Lord, the incident occurred Tuesday at about 18 hours at the Arangay Back Dam Cayuni River. The men's employer informed that James and the main suspect were drinking during the day when they started fighting. The employer said he broke up the fight and the suspect subsequently left. However, the suspect later returned with another person and started to beat James about the body and head. The employer said James's motionless body was discovered in a hammock in his camp about 6 hours on Wednesday. One person has so far been arrested and is in custody at the Aranga police station, while the main suspect is currently being sought. Despite the Guyana Human Rights Association and other organizations calling for mining to be delisted from the list of essential services, the Guyana Gold and Diamond Miners Association has rejected the calls.
During a private sector commission briefing, President of the Guyana Gold and Diamond Miners Association, Andron Alfonso, said that mining industry is accountable for a large contribution in the foreign exchange earnings. He explained if mining is scratched from the list, Guyana's foreign exchange earnings would drop and can lead to an economic crisis. Previously, Commissioner of the Guyana Geology and Mines Commission, Newell Renison, had stated that mining must continue. The Ghana Human Rights Association had called for strict rules against the movement on minors to limit the spread of the virus in Amerindian settlements. In Region 9, two shops are disallowing minors to pass through their villages. There are confirmed cases of the virus in Region 7. Luan Williams for MTV's News Update.
The Pan American Health Organization, World Health Organization, PAHO WHO, has accused Ghana of failing its fight against tobacco use. Resident rep of PAHO WHO, Dr. William Adukro, said although the National Tobacco Act was passed, it is yet to be implemented. Such an act can reduce the spread of non-communicable diseases, Dr. Adukro noted. He said the Public Health Ministry's fight against the substance is not serious. The health rep made the announcement in observance of World No Tobacco Day 2020. Factory workers from the Ayoflot Sugar Estate this morning continued protesting but were confronted by police officers who instructed them to disperse and end the picketing exercise.
The sugar workers are demanding that Gaisuku ensure there's adequate physical distancing at the Ayoflot factory and for the hours of work to be between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. The Ghana Agricultural and General Workers Union statement said the Ghana Sugar Corporation remains inflexible, though at the start of the out-of-crop period, it was agreed that workers would not work during the curfew period. According to the union, the sugar company during a meeting yesterday insisted that the sugar workers work during the curfew hours. The union is calling for the sugar company to relook at its decision in the interest of the health and safety of its workers. Sandy Ramutar for MTV's News Update.
The Ghana Telephone and Telegraph Company, GTT, will reopen its store in Camp and Robb Streets on June 1, 2020. This follows the reopening of its 55 Brickdam store and those in Essequibo, Linden and Berbice. Only 10 persons, including staff, will be allowed in the store and customers will be asked to stand 4 to 6 feet apart. Priority will also be given to seniors and essential workers between 8 a.m. to 9 a.m. More news still ahead. Stay tuned.
Hi, my name is Ramnirez Sarwan, former Guyana and West Indies cricketer. I would like to encourage everyone to practice social distancing. It's important that we stand at least 3 feet from others. I would also like to encourage you to avoid crowded areas. It's even more important for us to protect ourselves so we'll be able to protect others from COVID-19. Stay safe, everyone.
For further information, check our website www.health.gov.gy or visit the ministry's Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, or Twitter page.
Are you running around looking for construction materials? Well, run down to Lens for affordable, high-quality building supplies. We have the widest range of grade A floor and wall tiles in any shape, size, and designs. And all types of ceramics, porcelain glazed, and full body porcelain. We stock the largest collection of large format tiles. Check out our porcelain slabs as big as 10 feet by 4.5 feet. Add a bit of elegance with our large range of decorative molding. Our line of PPG paints will give you vibrant colors that won't fade. Our wall and ceiling gypsum system. It's light, durable, and fast. So come down to Lens at 136 Sherr Street, which is next to Buddy's and Pizza Hut, for that 31 years of Lens quality.
You can be a millionaire by only spending $100 on a Daily Million ticket. Simply pick any five numbers from 1 to 26, or you can buy a quick pick for your chance to win the Daily Millions. Purchase your tickets daily, Monday through Saturday, to get a chance to win $1 million every day. So, feeling lucky? Then buy a Daily Millions ticket today. Remember, a ticket today could make you rich today.
Thank you.
planning a cleanup? We can help. Sivan's Waste Management skip bins can be provided for home renovation projects, yard cleanups, or construction sites. It's simple. Step one, just pick up the phone and give us a call. Step two, we deliver the skip bin size of your choice. Step three, load the skip with all of your junk. And finally, step four, we take it all away. It's that simple. Bins are also available in various sizes, so there's no job that's too big or too small. Call Sivan's Waste Management today at 218-1455 or 218-1156.
Are you having sore throat, fever, coughing, headache, or runny nose? Take Cetamol Cold and Flu day or night. Ask your pharmacist for Cetamol Cold and Flu and get back to the happier you.
Distributed by Massey Distribution.
Are you having sore throat, fever, coughing, headache, or runny nose? Take Cetamol Cold and Flu day or night. Ask your pharmacist for Cetamol Cold and Flu and get back to the happier you.
Distributed by Massey Distribution.
Welcome to Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., Guyana's sole distributor of NP and Ultra Lubricants, SKF bearings, seal and belts, international trucks and parts, and Napa batteries. With a bond capacity of 30,000 square foot, we offer superior brands at affordable prices and the best after-sale service. ISG supplies sustainable integrated solutions to make your business a growing success. Visit us at our new main office at Lot 4Q, Peters Hall, ISG, the best opportunity to make the right choice.
And now for your sport news. An International Cricket Council board meeting set to discuss the fate of the T20 World Cup ended with the setting up of an independent investigation.
All actual items on the agenda, including decision about the next ICC chairman, were deferred to the next meeting on June 10. There was little detail about the investigation, other than it was brought to attention by several board members. Additionally, it would be headed by the ICC's ethics officer and supported by global experts. The board was meant to discuss whether or not to postpone the World Cup, scheduled for this October in Australia. On Wednesday, there were reports of the chances of postponement being at a high. However, the ICC said reports of postponement were inaccurate. There was to be a discussion that would lead towards finalizing an election process for the ICC chairman's position. Current chairman Shashank Manohar will not be contesting a third term. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV's Sports Update.
European Tour golfers will be encouraged to divulge their innermost thoughts when they resume playing in July. In a groundbreaking move, tournament bosses want players to wear television microphones while competing to enhance coverage of events played behind closed doors. Although professionals have worn mics during television broadcasts, such as last Sunday's charity match involving Tiger Woods and Phil Mickelson, this is a significant move for tour events. Viewers will hear conversations with caddies and fellow players, and European Tour Chief Executive Keith Pelly believes it will become the way of life at future events. In line with its decision to suspend all FIBA competitions, FIBA announced a new series of updates for the 2020 FIBA 3x3 season.
No FIBA 3x3 official competitions will occur before August 2020 due to the coronavirus pandemic. As a result, a number of events were wiped out across the world, including two Olympic qualifying tournaments now postponed. While a majority of events are still on course to be played in the third or fourth quarter of the year, a final decision will be made at a later date. FIBA remains committed to bringing 3x3 back in action in the remainder of 2020 and in January 2021 if needed. In addition, FIBA will continue to closely monitor the COVID-19 situation on a regular basis to communicate further updates. Chelsea Lee, reporter from MTV's Sports Update.
FIFA has issued guidelines relative to penalization of spitting and other related offenses during play in response.
This came from responses to organizers who have issued protocols recommending that players refrain from spitting and similar actions. FIFA advised, spitting at someone is a sending off offense under the laws of the game. However, where spitting does not fall into this category, it would be impractical to make it a yellow card offense. This is because it is impossible for match officials to detect every incident occurring at any time. Consequently, treating general spitting and other such actions as a yellow card offense during matches would lead to inconsistency and unfairness. FIFA noted where a competition wishes to enforce protocols, any disciplinary decision should be taken by the relevant authorities after the match. Chelsea Lee, reporting from MTV's Sports Update.
The Boston Marathon has been cancelled for the first time in its 124-year history because of the ongoing coronavirus pandemic. The race had initially been postponed from April 20 to September 14. However, Boston Mayor Marty Walsh said the race could not be held in 2019 because of the public health fears. Walsh said there is no way to hold the usual race format without bringing large numbers of people into close proximity. The event is the longest-running major annual marathon in the world, having been held every year since 1897. And that brings us to the end of Sport Update. More after the break.
Get the right seal right now from Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc., your immediate SKF sealing solutions. The SKF seal jet machine is capable of building seals from 5mm to 600mm in diameter in under 5 minutes. With technical support readily available, you can get a customized seal to suit virtually any industrial application, like buffer, rod, wiper, and piston seals. SKF seal jet machine, now at Industrial Supply of Guyana, Inc.
This is where we wrap up this evening's broadcast, but before we go, here's a reminder of our top stories. GCOM moves deadline for national votes recount to June 13. GCOM commissioner says allegations of migrants voting forwarded to chief immigration officer. Dr. Ali roasts Vincent Alexander over statements made. COVID-19 task force rejects the establishment of more counting stations, recount to drag on. And in sport, ICC deferred decision on 2020 T20 World Cup to June 10. Catch our rebroadcasts at 23 hours today and at 6 hours 30 tomorrow. On behalf of our news and technical teams, I am Ashley Scotland. Good night.